The Siva Purana Part 1 Published by Motilal Banarsidass Publishers PVT Limited, Delhi 2002 Siva Purana Mahatmyam Siva Purana, Vijayasvara Samhita Chapter 2 Answers Clarifying the Doubts of the Sages Sutta said 1. O saintly men, the question that you put me is very pertinent. Prompted by my love towards you all I shall, remembering my preceptor, the benefactor of the three worlds, tell you everything. All of you listen attentively. 2. The entire essence of Vedanta is contained in the excellent Siva Purana. It dispels all sins. It affords the attainment of the highest truth, Brahma, hereafter. 3. O Brahmins, the great glory of Siva, that destroys the sin of the Kali Age, unfolds itself in the Purana and yields the fruits of the four varieties, Dharma, Artha, Kama and Moksha. 4. By the single-minded study of that most excellent Siva Purana, excellent Brahmins will attain salvation. 5. It is only as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world, that Brahmahatya, the sin of slaying a Brahmin, and other sins display themselves. 6. It is only as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world, that the evil portents of Kali fearlessly roam about. 7. It is only as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world, that the different sacred texts clash together in disputation. 8. It is difficult, even to great men, to comprehend Siva's features, as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world. 9. The cruel attendants of Yama roam about fearlessly, as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world. 10. All the other Puranas roar loudly on the earth, as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world. 11. All the holy centers enter into mutual wrangles and disputes on the earth, as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world. 12. All the mantras rejoice in mutual disputes, as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world. 13. All the sectors of pilgrimage engage themselves in mutual disputes, as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world. 14. All the altars and pedestals engage themselves in mutual disputes, as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world. 15. All the gifts engage themselves in disputes, as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world. 16. All those gods engage themselves in mutual disputes, as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world. 17. All the philosophical tenets engage themselves in mutual disputes, as long as the Siva Purana has not risen high in the world. 18. O foremost among Brahmanical sages, I cannot adequately describe the fruit accruing from reciting and listening to this Siva Purana. 19. Even then, O sinless ones, I shall succinctly describe its greatness as narrated to me by Vyasa. Please listen attentively. 20. He who reads a single stanza, or even half of it piously, becomes free from sin instantaneously. 21. He who reads every day as much of Siva Purana as he can, with devotion and alertness, is called Jivanmukta, a living liberated soul. 22. He who continues to worship this Siva Purana daily, derives the fruit of horse sacrifice undoubtedly. 23. He who, with a craving for an ordinary position in life, listens to Siva Purana even from a person other than me, is freed from sin. 24. He who bows near this Siva Purana, derives undoubtedly, the fruit of adoration of all the gods. 25. Please listen to the meritorious benefit that accrues to the man who copies Siva Purana, and gives the manuscript to the devotees of Siva. 26. He will have that benefit, very difficult to attain in the world, as that of the study of sastras, sacred lore, and of commenting on the Vedas. 27. He who observes fast on the Katadasi, 14th day in the lunar fortnight, and conducts discourses and comments on the Siva Purana, in the assembly of the devotees of Siva, is the most excellent of all. 28. He shall derive the benefit of the repetition of Gayatri, syllable by syllable. He will enjoy all worldly pleasures here, and attain salvation hereafter. 29. I shall tell you the benefit derived by him who reads or listens to this, after observing fast on the Katadasi day, by keeping awake in the night. 30-31. This is the truth, undoubtedly the truth, that he will get the benefit derived by the man who makes gifts of wealth, equal in weight to himself, to Brahmins with Vyasas at their head, at the complete eclipse of the sun, many a time in all holy centers, Kurukshetra, etc. 32. Indra and other devas wait eagerly for the directives of the man who chants day and night the verses of the Siva Purana. 33. The sacred rites, performed by the man who regularly reads or listens to the Siva Purana, are effective millions of times more than usual. 34. He who reads the Rudra Samhita portion of Siva Purana with pure and concentrated mind becomes a purified soul within 3 days, even though he might have killed a Brahmin. 35. He who reads the Rudra Samhita 3 times a day near the image of Bhairava, refraining from useless talk, shall get all cherished desires fulfilled. 36. If a slayer of Brahmin circumambulates the trees of Vata and Bilva, reciting the verses from Rudra Samhita, he will become purified of the sin of Brahmin slaughter. 37. The Kailasa Samhita is even greater than that. It is of Vedic status and stature. The meaning of Pranava, the sacred syllable Om, is amplified in it. 38. O Brahmins, Lord Siva knows the greatness of Kailasa Samhita in its entirety. Vyasa knows half of it, and I am moiety of the same. 39. A part of it I shall tell you, since it is impossible to say everything. On comprehending it, people attain purity of their minds instantaneously. 40. O Brahmins, seeking for it ever and anon, I do not see a sin that cannot be quelled by Rudra Samhita. 41. Drinking that nectar prepared by Lord Siva, after churning the ocean of the Upanishads, a class of Vedic literature, and handed over to Kumara, Lord Kartikeya, the devotee shall become immortal. 42. The person intending to perform expiatory rites for the sins of Brahmahatya etc. should read that Samhita for a month. He shall be freed of that sin. 43. By a single recital that Samhita destroys the sin, originating from the acceptance of monetary gifts from defiled persons, partaking of defiled food and indulging in foul talks. 44. The benefit derived by a person who reads that Samhita in the grove of Bilva trees, in a temple of Siva, is beyond description in words. 45. If a person reads that Samhita with devotion at the time of performing Shraddha and feeding the Brahmins, all his P3s, means, attain the great region of Siva. 46. The devotee who observes fast on the Katadasi day and reads that Samhita under the Bilva tree is directly identified with Siva and is worshipped by the gods. 47. The other Samhitas are, no doubt, the bestowers of the benefit of fulfilling all cherished desires. These 2 Samhitas are particularly excellent, as they are full of divine sports and divine knowledge. 48. Such is the Siva Purana, extolled on a par with the Vedas, created by Lord Siva himself at first, and commensurate with the Supreme Brahman. 49-51. Originally the Siva Purana was of very enormous size, consisting of 12 sacred Samhitas. 1. Vijayasvara. 2. Rudra. 3. Vinayaka. 4. Omika. 5. Maitri. 6. Rudreka Dasa. 7. Kailasa. 8. Sata Rudraka. 9. Sahasra Kot Rudra. 10. Koti Rudra. 11. Vayavya and 12. Dharma Samjana. O Brahmins, I shall mention the number of verses in those Samhitas. Please listen with due attention. 52. The first Samhita of Vijayasvara consisted of 10,000 verses. The Rudra, Vinayaka, Omika and Maitri Samhitas consisted of 8,000 verses each. 53. O Brahmins, the Rudreka Dasa Samhita consisted of 13,000 verses, the Kailasa Samhita of 6,000 verses and the Satarudra of 3,000 verses. 54. The Koti Rudra Samhita consisted of 9,000 verses, the Sahasra Kot Rudra Samhita, of 11,000 verses. 55. The Vayavya Samhita consisted of 4,000 verses, and the Dharma Samhita of 12,000 verses. Thus, the whole Shiva Purana contained 100,000 verses. 56. That has been condensed by Vyasa to 24,000 verses. That is to about a fourth of the original Purana, and he retained 7 Samhitas. 57. The Puranic lore, at the time of the first creation as conceived by Shiva, contained 1,000,000,100 crores, verses. 58. In the Krita Age, Dwaipayana and others condensed it into 400,000 verses, which in the beginning of Dwapara Age, was separated into 18 different Puranas. 59. Of these, the Shiva Purana contains 24,000 verses, with 7 Samhitas, and the Purana is on a par with the Vedas, in excellence. 60. The first Samhita is called Vijayasvara, the second Rudra, the third Satarudra and the fourth Koti Rudra. 61. The fifth is Ami, of Uma, the sixth, Kailasa and the seventh, Vayavya, these are the 7 Samhitas. 62. Thus, the divine Shiva Purana, with its 7 Samhitas stands on a par with the Vedas, according salvation more than anything else. 63. He who reads this Shiva Purana, complete with the 7 Samhitas devotedly, is a living liberated soul. 64. Hundreds of other sacred texts, as the Vedas, Smritis, Puranas, Itihasas, and Agamas, do not merit even a 16th of this Shiva Purana. 65. Shiva Purana is first expounded by Shiva and then condensed by Vyasa, a devotee of Shiva. It is pure and brief. And as such, it renders help to all living beings. As sequela of the threefold calamities, physical, extraneous and divine, it is unrivaled. It bestows welfare upon the good. 66-67. Undeceptive virtue is extolled herein. It is in the main, of the nature of Vedantic wisdom. It contains mantras and 3 aims of life. And the thing knowable by wise men of unprejudiced mind. The Shiva Purana is the best among the Puranas, extolling the great being that glows in Vedanta and the Vedas. He who reads and listens to it, with devotion, becomes a favorite of Shiva. And attains the supreme position, here and hereafter. If you enjoyed this audiobook, please like and subscribe to be notified of when new audiobooks are uploaded. Thank you for listening and learning. Shanti.